Hi, I'm Tawny from Utah's Hogle Zoo, and today we're going to talk about boreal toads. Boreal toads are native to Utah. They're found in a variety of mountainous wetland habitats. These include slow-moving streams, lakes, marshes, alpine meadows, and beaver ponds. They are gray or greenish in color with dark blotching on their back and belly. They have a distinct white stripe running down their back, though this isn't visible on juvenile toads. And yes, they do have really big warts, but no, if kissed, they don't turn into a prince. Adults are between 3.5 and 4.5 inches long, with the females being larger than the males. They can live up to 12 years and eat mostly small invertebrates. This can include spiders, worms, ants, moths, and beetles. As toads, they're part of the amphibian family, just like frogs, newts, and salamanders. Amphibians are tetrapod vertebrate animals. The word amphibian comes from the Greek word amphibios, meaning double life. This is because amphibians go through two main stages in life, one in water and one on the land. Their eggs are laid in the water, and when they hatch, they have gills, like fish, to breathe oxygen. Then they go through a metamorphosis, and their body changes. They grow lungs and four legs so they can live on land. They are cold-blooded and do not have scales. They can be found in a variety of habitats on all the continents except Antarctica. Amphibians generally have a thin skin that is covered in a layer of protective mucus. Can you imagine if we were the same way? It would be like us wearing snot. Thankfully, we don't have to wear snot to survive, but amphibians, they do. Amphibians use their skin for a variety of purposes, so it needs to stay healthy and protected. They can use their skin to breathe. Imagine a frog hanging out at the bottom of a pond. Instead of having to swim all the way to the top of the water to get a breath of air, where a predator might eat them, he can instead absorb oxygen right where he is, safely at the bottom of the pond. They also use their skin to drink water. They absorb water right through their skin. However, amphibians can also absorb other things through their skin, including pollution and toxins. Because of their amazing ability to absorb things through their skin, they're also one of the first animals to be affected by changes in the ecosystem. This makes them an indicator species. Scientists study amphibian populations around the world to tell how healthy the environment is. Utah's Hogle Zoo partners with the Utah Division of Natural Resources to do toad surveys multiple times a year, and we've been doing this since 2008.
My name is Kaylee Mullen and I work for Utah's Hogle Zoo as the Citizen Science Wildlife Biologist. Today we are looking for the boreal toad. The boreal toad is a subspecies of the western toad and it's native here in Utah. We're looking in the willow and we're looking along the creek side with the hope of finding them and taking some biometric data, so their length and their weight, and just checking the general health of the population here. So when we find a toad, the first thing we do is scan it with a pit tag reader for a little pit tag. If it has been found before, we will have tagged it. And a pit tag is essentially the same as when you microchip your pet dog and it has its name and address on, and the vet can scan it if it gets lost. Whereas a pit tag has a unique number unique to that toad, so we can tell individuals apart. We also swab it with what looks like a Q-tip, and then this is going to be sent off to a lab and to check if it has chytrid. Chytrid is a fungus that lives on the skin of an amphibian, and it will harden the skin, making it harder for the amphibian eventually to move, but primarily for any water or gas exchange the amphibian needs to do to live a healthy life. We always wear gloves, and we use these gloves one time per toad. The same with our equipment, it's always cleaned before and after, and this will help prevent moving any fungal disease between each individual. So if you're out and about and you see a boreal toad, you can go and you can look at it and get excited about it, but don't pick it up, don't ever touch any amphibian. And this will help prevent spreading chytrid, and it will keep the wild animals wild and happy.
Boreal toads are awesome amphibians that live right here in Utah. They eat bugs and have permeable skin, which means that they are very easily affected by even the smallest changes to their environment. We'll be right back.